Church on North Avenue in Thomas, Ohio, broadcasting via FM radio 93.7, also live streaming via our parish Facebook page. We are about to begin the celebration of the 5 p.m. vigil mass for the 19th Sunday of ordinary time. A reminder to anyone who may be praying with us from the parking lot, at communion time, a minister will come out to the covered walkway to distribute communion to anyone praying with us from the parking lot. At that time, please come forward to receive communion and kindly return to your vehicle for the remainder of this celebration. For any unable to come forward, once those who are able have done so, then please drive up to the covered walkway and a minister will bring communion to you while you are in your vehicle. Again, and simply return to your spot in the parking lot for the remainder of this celebration. Thank you, and we will begin shortly.
Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we come before our God. divine garrisons, and so preparing to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come to us in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
A reading from the book, first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak, and went out and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on a mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against him. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said. They cried out in fear. At once, Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This weekend, we're given a portion of the 14th chapter of Matthew, and some 10 chapters prior, Jesus was already very much engaged in public ministry. Jesus has already called the disciples, he did that in chapter 4, extending, if you will, his hand to them at that time. To Simon Peter, to Andrew, to James, John, to others, fishermen, familiar with the sea, its bounty and its barrenness, its beauty and its ugliness, its peace and its calm, as well as its turbulence. He stretched out his hand with the invitation, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." No questions asked, they left their nets at once and any other activity they were engaged in, and they did just that. By now, he's gone all around Galilee. He's taught in the synagogues. He's proclaimed the gospel of the kingdom. He's cured every disease and illness. His fame has spread. People have followed. There's been the Sermon on the Mount. And he has preached and taught on many things. He's taught about prayer. He's taught about the need for dependence on God, about not judging others. He's cleansed a leper. He's healed the centurion's servant. He's even cured Peter's mother-in-law. He caused amazement by already calming one storm at sea. He missioned and commissioned the 12. He spoke of the coming persecutions for believers, but encouraging them to be courageous. It was very clear that he would be the cause of division, clear about the conditions of discipleship. He spoke about who his true family is. He's taught in parables. He spoke of new and old treasures. He's reminded others that he was the fulfillment of the law and the prophets. He's even grieved over the death of John the Baptist, and he spent 5,000 men, not counting women and children. So with that list, undeniably, Jesus has proven himself to be who unclean spirits have attested he is, and who others have proclaimed. And he's not wavered. He's remained steadfast and focused on moving to Jerusalem and what must take place there. Which is why, my friends, to a certain extent, this particular gospel story may seem a bit surprising. At least, Peter's faltering that is. "Come," Jesus said to Peter. And Peter begins to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. He became frightened when he took his eyes off the Lord. And so, beginning to sink, he cries out, "Lord, save me." Peter falters, but the Lord remains steadfast. And his actions should be of no surprise to us. Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and he caught Peter. "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" Getting into the boat, the wind dies down. Those in the boat do him homage. "Truly, you are the Son of God." It's a familiar story. You know, when we look at our churches, I shared once before, most churches, including ours, they're shaped like a great ark. Upside down, of course, but still an ark. And they symbolize in many ways how the church, the baptized, is to set out on the seas of this world to catch others, to bring them to the Lord, to set out on the seas even in rough and turbulent times. Especially at those times when the Lord says to us, "Come." When he stretches out his hand so that we may grab on, so that you and I and others may not falter. He is our stability. And we're to focus on him. And focusing on him allows us to maintain our bearings through such rough times and tough seas. You, I, the church, the world, in particular, our state of Ohio at this time, we are afloat. And perhaps it feels as if we're on some very, very rough seas at this time. But the Lord says to all, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Once again, he calls us to not remain stuck amid the turbulent time, but to come to him. This coming November, we, Ohioans, will be asked to cast our vote on a change to our state constitution that threatens the very dignity and respect of all human life, from conception until natural death. I need to say this clearly. Be aware, this is not only about abortion. Yes, a preeminent concern that is and remains, but it also is very much about taking away parental rights for controlling and managing health care and medical interventions for their children and you, for your children and your youth, your grandchildren and your nieces and nephews. The proposed amendment now reads, and I quote, "Every individual has a right to make and carry out one's own reproductive decisions, including but not limited to." And then there are some that are enumerated, but not all. Be concerned, my friends. Every individual is not qualified in the amendment. There's no age range. There's no limitation whatsoever. Now, I am not naive in realizing that there's still a great deal of work that needs to be done in helping to form consciences that recognize the sacredness of all human life, from conception until natural death. I am not naive enough when poll after poll tells us that many Catholics do not oppose abortion, do not oppose the death penalty, do not oppose euthanasia, and the list of life issues goes on. So yes, we have much, much work and prayer to devote ourselves to actually do in this area. But I also pray that none of us is naive enough to allow for the elimination of parental rights when it comes to managing the health care and medical interventions for our children and our youth. For that is very, very much at stake in the November election in the state of Ohio. and travel. We travel together at this time. And as we do, let us trust that the Lord's response remains the same today as it did centuries ago. The Lord who stretches out his hand to catch us, to help us back into the boat so that we may continue to move forward to a culture of life for all human persons, regardless of the stage that life is in, and so calm the wind and cause the turbulent waves to subside. For Jesus will not let us sink. Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid. Come to me. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us as men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death in the grave, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. And he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the midst of the storms of life and time, Jesus calls out to all to come, extending his hand to all who cry out to him, drawing them to a deeper life in God. Because of this, we're confident in our prayer this day and always.
That the disciples of the Lord Jesus may not grow discouraged with the winds and waves of secularism, unbelief, and the many challenges of our time, but take heart in Jesus, who will lead all to faith in God and new life in him, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations, battered by the storms of war, ethnic hatred, poverty, famine, especially the Ukraine, portions of Africa, and the Americas, may come one day to rejoice in peace, reconciliation, prosperity, healing, and renewed health, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people of goodwill may reach out their hands, as the Lord did toward Peter, and come to the aid of victims of abuse, poverty, famine, and violence, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who serve and protect, whether near or far, may be kept safe from harm, and that the innocent victims of war may be restored to peace and wholeness of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the hand of grace the Lord extends to us at our common table may strengthen us in faith, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as so many administrators, faculties, staffs, students, and families their sacrifice, hard work, and desire to do so safely may be strengthened and bear good fruit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the citizens of Ohio may with awe for the gift of all human life, act to protect all human life, especially the preborn, their mothers and fathers, accompanying expectant mothers and fathers in need, and striving to protect parental rights, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may always be a place of welcome and calm, a safe haven for all who strive to conform their lives more and more to Christ and his gospel, regardless of race, sex, or sexual orientation, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and suffering, especially Robert Breyer, Kelly Castle, John Chartarina, Bob Christian, Agnes Clark, Mary Dunkey, James Fairhead, Danny Firth, Floss Firth, Mike Firth, Deja Furtney, Robert Jiat, Julian Jenkins, Dan Lane, Mary Lombardo, Jonathan Warkowski, Tom Warkowski, Dora Katropi, Carol Scaley, George Serva Jr., Katrina Schunk, Paula Simmons, Giovanni Testa, Tina Testa, Janet Treat, as well as the victims and survivors of clergy sexual abuse in our church, may find in us the support and visible sign of Christ's presence, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Deacon Carlos Rivera, Thomas Dan Miller, son of Bev Dan Miller, who have recently died, for Beverly Finn, for whom this Mass is offered, and for all who have died, may be taken by the hand of Christ, who will lead them safely to the haven of eternal life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the intentions of those listed in our prayer notes book, as well as the intentions that lie within our minds and hearts, along with those we have been asked to pray for through our renewal recommitment initiative, may all find favor with God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Strong and faithful God, your outstretched arm governs the mighty forces of creation, and your gentle hand fails even the smallest of creatures. Strengthen our little faith, and open our eyes to your presence at every moment of history and in every circumstance of life, that we may walk with Christ through every storm toward safe haven and true peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Chant. Let's sing together, We Walk by Faith, and it's number 514.
Yeah.
acceptable to God for all mankind. By your power, you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Lord,
giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Our communion chant, we sing together, "Be Not Afraid," and it's number 438.
Thank you.
May the communion in your son that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Always thank you, giving of your time and talent to support your parish's mission and ministry, and also for those who are giving of the gift of treasure. Our local users, just a reminder, please do use the collection boxes at the entrance of the church. Do not forget your bulletins. There's two key inserts this weekend. And take fives are also near the entrance of the church. Remember, Acme Community Cashback started last week. And so we bring in your receipts, turn them in, drop them in the collection boxes, and we'll take it from there. But it's extended through a longer period of time than it has been in the past. So check last week's insert with regard to that. A reminder that this Tuesday is the Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. It is a holy day of observation. Masses will be at 8:30 a.m. and 7 p.m. If anyone is bringing flowers, we ask that you please bring them to the church by noon on Monday. That's August 14th. So again, thank you in advance for your consideration. The deadline for, and first of all, you need to know we already took, I should say, Linda Harold did, took one delivery of school supplies already to St. Anthony's School, so thank you very much. We need to leave space for more. And so, remember the deadline is next Sunday, whether it be the school supplies or whether it be a cash donation that we'll forward to them, whatever, just to help the students at that school or in that area. Because Monday is their Meet the Teacher night, that evening, so we want to make sure that everyone will be meeting. You'll see one of the inserts is, in the bulletin this week deals with our mission appeal this year. It's a bit different. It will take place the weekend of August 26th or 27th, although if you're a Faith Direct person or not, you can go online right now and start to contribute to that. And the intention is to support the Catholic community of Our Lady of Guadalupe and the parish of Our Lady of the Incarnation. It's located in a very small town, and I am not going to try to pronounce it, in a diocese in Guatemala. It's a long story, but some months ago, over a year ago, we were connected with them. We provided some funds because we had received an unexpected gift. We were aware of them. Jeff Craig, who is the daughter of Joyce and Jerry Craig, brought it to our attention, and it's just been a wonderful story. So, read the insert. They're building this from the ground up, and they're using all the labor that they have and all the funds that they can raise. And it's not just Catholics who are building it. It's a bunch of people who are constructing this. So we provided some pictures too. So again, check that out. We're excited about this year's mission appeal, and we know it's going to go to it. It's just a great, great cause. Just a reminder too that next Saturday is Circle Fest. You can get to church, you can get home by way of the Circle Fest. But anyhow, we hope that you participate and join that. Last but not least, another insert in the bulletin. If you can believe it, we're coming up on 80 years. 80 years of the anniversary for the 80th anniversary of the naming of the parish, which is October 7th, the memorial of Our Lady of the Rosary. And then next December, December 8th, 2024, will be the 80th anniversary of the founding of the parish. So we've got some pieces in place, and there will be more information and more engagement, if you will. But two pieces we have in place because of their schedules. On Saturday evening, September 30th, Bishop Michael Boost, the auxiliary bishop of the Diocese of Cleveland, will be here presiding, preach, and we'll have a little reception afterwards. So we hope folks will join in on that. That will be to celebrate the naming. And then on December 7th, which is also a Saturday, which will be the vigil mass for the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of Mary, Bishop Blessing will be here to preside and preach. So we're very excited about that. So we've got the beginning and the end. We just have to fill in the and we'll work on that with you all. So just stay tuned. But all that just like kind of came down this week. So we're excited to announce it. Again, check the bulletin insert and mark your calendars. The Lord be with you.
Amen.